can go.
Dear Dr. Smith and distinguished members of the Board of Education, my name is Sonia Thanacott. I'm co-president of the SGA at Neelsville Middle School. I am here today to ask the board to please approve Dr. Smith's recommendation for a brand new Neelsville Middle School. I would also like to thank Dr. Smith for our new Neelsville Middle School sign at the front of our building. Over the last 3 years, things at Neelsville have continued to deteriorate. One of the main concerns is that students still do not feel safe and secure at Neelsville. Brianna will elaborate on that right after me. Our leaking skylight got fixed, but the solution took away most of the main source of natural light we have at our school. Teachers in classrooms with no windows, as in a lot of the classrooms, have put up fake painted windows to feel like there is some connection to the outside world. We still have 4 lunch blocks that was started last year, but with long wait times for food, it doesn't always give students enough time to eat. The closest bathrooms to the cafeteria has 1 stall for girls, 1 stall for boys, and 1 stall for staff. Many of our classrooms are loud and overcrowded. There are even classrooms without enough desks for all the students to use. In 6th grade, we had a weight room with equipment that was used for gym classes, but in order to create more classrooms, we lost our weight room, and the main gym is divided for 2 classes to share. We don't have an elevator to accommodate students with crutches or wheelchairs. We have a very long, winding, dangerous ramp that isn't in compliance with the Americans with Disabilities Act. There are many, many more issues at Neelsville that can't be covered in 3 minutes. I'm here today because I believe that every student deserves a great facility to learn in, but it's clear we don't have that at Neelsville when students from not just our school, but other schools have called us the prison on the hill. What happens won't affect me, but I don't want future kids to have to put up with the same issues I did. This new facility is essential to creating a more positive learning environment at Neelsville. So I ask the board to please approve the fiscal year 2020 budget for a new Neelsville Middle School. Thank you for your time.
Thank you. Thank you. Now we'll hear from Brianna Akumoa-Boateng.
Close enough. Dear Dr. Smith and the distinguished members of the board, my name is Brianna Akumoa-Boateng, and I'm the other co-president of Neelsville's SGA. Neelsville is extremely appreciative that we are being recommended for this funding for our new school, but we desperately need it to be secured for us. The staff and student safety is constantly at risk when it comes to entering our building. All you have to do to get in is press a button for the office to open the door. But where the office is positioned, they can't even see who is coming in, meaning virtually anyone at any time can enter our building. And despite it being a sensitive topic, school shootings are becoming a prevalent occurrence, with over 20 already happening this year. Our safety is on the line, and we can't stay defenseless anymore. Outside security aside, the inside of our school also needs a major security improvement. The exits of our building are fire hazards because in case of an emergency, we cannot all be filed out in a safe amount of time. Furthermore, as Sonia stated, we do not have enough bathrooms to accommodate all of our students, which is severely unhygienic. This year, we actually instilled a rule for our upper floor to be used as a one-way hallway because in the years prior, there was an intersection that got so filled up every time the bell rang that it caused countless stalemates and was the perfect place if you wanted to be trampled or hurt. The one-way hallway doesn't completely fix this either. When your class is hardly across the hall but you have to go all the way around to reach it, students are certainly running the moment the bell rings, leaving everyone in their wake an obstacle that will be hurt in the process. And lastly, I want you to imagine having hundreds of students walking a single hallway, being packed like a can of sardines, being herded like cattle in one direction. This cramped and stuffy atmosphere isn't a suitable learning environment, and school is stressing enough without having to worry how badly you're going to be hurt every time you exit the bell rings. Neelsville is a safety hazard to all of its students and staff, and will continue to be one until we are fixed. Please take that into consideration. Thank you.
Thank you.